Hi, this is Naomi with the Top Shelf VA channel. You are probably wondering why in the world would I allow myself to record myself in such poor lighting and have my camera settings set so poorly and I look like this. You probably also think that you can only do color correction in some expensive software such as Adobe Premiere. And you've probably heard that Camtasia 9 now has some color correction, but it's okay. Well, guess what? I'm here to show you that you can go from this to this in Camtasia 9 by using three features in Camtasia 9. And I'm about to show you how you can do it. If you can go from this to this, you can do almost anything you want with color correction in Camtasia 9. So let's go ahead and go to the software and see how it's done. Come on, let's go. A quick reminder to hit the subscribe button and notification bell so you don't miss anything, especially if you are someone who likes an eclectic selection of training videos for business and life. I've done a split screen here so you can see the before on the left and our progression as we move to the final results. Now keep in mind, 99% of the time, you hopefully will not be working with a video clip as horrible as this because it's nearly impossible to get something this bad to perfection. However, if we can get close enough with something this bad, you will be able to get to near perfection with any video that's just a little off. Now let's go ahead and put a color wheel in the bottom left corner here to help you understand a little about how to handle color as we work along. Basically, what to keep in mind is when working with a color in video, if we want to counterbalance that color, we'll also be working with the opposite hues on the color wheel. One example would be oranges or reddish oranges can be counterbalanced with cyans or blues. The same for any of the other colors on the wheel. You'll either be working with a specific color or its opposite color on the wheel. Okay. So we'll set up the three Camtasia features we are going to work with and set the defaults before we start making the color correction or color grading adjustments. Click on Visual Effects, then drag Colorize onto the clip on the canvas or drag it to the clip on the track. Drag the percentage amount down to zero. Next, drag Remove a Color onto the clip and move the tolerance and softness to zero. Your hue should also be at zero. Next, move the color adjustment onto the clip. Yuck! Not sure why Camtasia doesn't automatically have this set correctly. Anyway, set the brightness, contrast, and saturation to zero. Now we're ready to start making our adjustments. What we will do is make our first initial adjustments on all three features. When it's close enough, we'll then tweak each one slightly if needed. Let's go back up to the Colorize feature. We know from what we discussed that if we want to counterbalance the orange-reddish color, we will need to add cyan or blue. I like to start with the cyan color, so let's click on the drop-down arrow, select the color picker, and pick the cyan from the color wheel. Or if you don't have a color wheel, you can pick the color from the color bar here. We'll now move the amount percentage slide bar up until we see some of the color starting to even out. Obviously, the cyan is too strong, so I'll open the color dropdown and move to a lighter cyan and adjust the percentage amount a little. Remember, we'll be making other adjustments and coming back to tweak this if needed. Okay, on to the Camtasia Remove a Color feature. Right now, I think I want to add some blue because it's looking a little yellowish. Since this is the remove a color hue, what we know from the color wheel is if we remove yellow or orange, we'll get some variation of blue or purple. So let's start with the yellow color. Let's click on the drop down and select yellow, then move the hue percentage bar to the right. Same as before. If I want to adjust this a little, I'll click on the drop-down to open the color palette and adjust the yellow location, maybe down a little bit. Okay, on to the color adjustment feature. Now here you have to be a little careful. Brightness here is not a true brightness of the hue of the color, but simply adding light, thus making it white, or removing light, thus making it black. Here I prefer putting my cursor in the box next to the brightness, rather than using the slider, and hitting my up arrow key to slightly brighten it. I don't want it to look too washed out. The contrast is really dealing with what is called gamma and deals with the luminance of the color. It makes the color more intense or grayed out. Once again, I like putting my cursor in the box and using my up and down arrow keys rather than the slider. I have more control this way, and the Camtasia color adjustments require a finer touch. Saturation will help bring in a little bit more color. Same thing, cursor in the box, and I use the up arrow to add some more color onto the clip. Now it's time to fine tweak everything. I start with the color correction, and this time I only work with the color drop-down map. The first thing I do is I copy the color I currently have by highlighting it and Ctrl plus C to copy. This is just in case I mess it up too badly in my experimenting and I want to quickly go back to the original color I had selected. I'll then move either the bar slightly or the cursor slightly to see if there are any changes I prefer. That's pretty good. Now down to remove a color, and let's see what adjustments, if any, I want to make. Same deal, copy the color in case I mess up so badly I want to quickly go back. Okay, we're getting there. Let's go back to the color adjustment. I think all I need to do is increase the saturation a little and maybe slightly on the brightness and contrast. Okay, I'm going to go back quickly to change some more of the color in remove a color and color correction for even more fine tuning. Simply keep doing this until you find the settings you like. Obviously, it would be hard to get perfect color because I was working with something so outlandishly out of whack, but think what you could do with a clip that only needed minor tweaking. Think of what you can do with this color correction or color grading technique if you simply wanted to intensify colors in a clip, or if you wanted to give a clip a vintage look, or even help sell the fact the sun is setting in a clip. The opportunities to make various color corrections abound and are only limited by your imagination. If you have a question and would like me to create a Camtasia tutorial video for you, simply subscribe to the channel, like this video, and leave a comment below. Feel free to share this video on any of your other social media platforms and encourage your friends to subscribe to the Top Shelf VA channel. As always, this is Naomi with TopshelfVA.com. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.